Four sectors plus one. I'm adding plus one because I'm treating the public service as a small additional. Maybe I should say four sectors and a half, because I don't count public service as really a full sector. In Somalia, our people in Somalia, they have four clans and a half. So that's why I got the idea that the medicine for poverty are the four sectors and a half. With these few words, it is when we talk of poverty, we have seen that we cannot solve poverty by witchcraft. If you go to the witch doctor, you will not solve it. We are not going to solve poverty by begging. There's also another problem of trying to solve poverty, especially in the countries which are a bit all right, which are a bit better off. This is the welfare approach, especially the Western countries, where the government gives free money to the integration. In Uganda here, we have been having a problem within agriculture. Because Africans are very democratic, certainly the ones in Uganda. If somebody has got, if a family has 3 acres of land and there are 6 people, when the head of the family dies or goes to heaven, the children, the 6 of them, democratically divide the land. They have taken democracy a bit too far. So what was 3 acres divided by 6 now becomes half an acre, half an acre. Now the problem is that some of the things which you can do in 100 acres and you make profit, if you try to do them in half an acre, you will not make profit. So that's why, therefore, again here in Uganda, we have been struggling to tell people that, please, cut your coat according to your cloth. If you have got a smaller piece of land, there are certain things you cannot make money from, like sugarcane, ebikado, like tobacco, like even cotton, even tea. Ranching, you cannot do ranching on half an acre. We are advising our people here, therefore, that when you have got a small piece of land, there are certain enterprises which you can do on a small scale, which you cannot do on a big scale. So that one also, that angle must also be understood, because people get into poverty by doing what the English call putting a square peg in a round hole, trying to do what cannot be done. If you try to grow cotton, to grow tobacco on a smaller scale, you will not get money. Even maize. Hemorrhage of money and jobs is. It is not only for cotton, for coffee, for cocoa, for minerals, for leather, for. So therefore, these four sectors must not only be four, but they must be integrated. They must be linked. Agriculture should produce raw materials for industry. And industry should produce machinery for agriculture. Good. And chemicals. You talk of agriculture. Where are the machinery for agriculture coming from? Most of the time they are coming from outside. How about the chemicals, the inputs? Maybe they are coming from outside. So all those are hemorrhages that creates unhealthy outflow from Africa. We need to trade with other countries. We cannot just do things alone. But the trade should be healthy, should be based. We should do all the things that we can do well, and other people do other things which they can do well, and then we exchange. But the problem is that even the things we can do well, we don't do. That's where the problem is, the poverty. So apart from the four sectors, this is public service. Public service. Because that one is there, working for the government or the local government. But the problem why I don't concentrate on that is that the public service jobs are limited. You cannot have endless jobs. You will get one school teacher per classroom. You will have one sub-county chief for one sub-county. If you have too many, they will have nothing to do. So the government jobs, they are limited. Uganda has got a population of 42 million people, but the public service jobs are like 400,000, 400-something thousand. Even if you assume that each civil servant has got 5 people in his home, including himself, you are talking of 400,000, we're talking about 2 million people. Are they 2 million? 4 times, 400,000 times 5. I think it's 2 million. But then how about the other 40 million? They can't benefit from the public service. So therefore, the real source of medicine for poverty eradication are the other 4 sectors, because these ones have no limit depending on the endowments of the respective countries. But this abolish poverty, are we going to use magic? Are we going to use witchcraft? How shall we abolish poverty? If you can use witchcraft, then you go ahead. However, can you abolish poverty by begging? Or if you don't use witchcraft, maybe you beg. Can you beg and abolish poverty? It seems the answers are no. Witchcraft will not work. Begging will not work. So, what will work? The way to abolish poverty is through each family in Uganda and in Africa participating in the production of goods and services which can be sold in the market, the production of goods or services. If each family is engaged in the production of a good or a service, then poverty may be addressed. Where, in which sectors are these jobs and services found? Which sectors? Sector number one is commercial agriculture. If families engage in commercial agriculture, they produce goods, agricultural goods, that can be sold within Uganda, within the region, or internationally. then they may be able to address poverty, because they will be paid for their goods, and that money will help them to solve the problems we are talking about. The problem of shelter, which the Undersecretary General was talking about, to build a better house. The problem of clothing. The problem of transport. Instead of walking, you can be able to buy a motorcycle. The problem of some aspects of health, education, safe water, because even when the water is connected and it is safe, it must be paid for. We cannot provide free water, even if it is safe. So, when I think about poverty, eradication, the one sector I think about is agriculture. And with agriculture, of course, you can add something else. You can also have food security. So that you have two things. First, you have food security, but you also earn income from what you sell. The second sector.
The president has said that there is no time to waste, there is time to fight poverty. We will say the anthems, and that is an executive order that we will respect.
I want more.